everybody to another Endless Theory event.
Feel the intensity in the crowd and on the racetrack.
They're saying he's going to be the one to watch today.
All these drivers all with one goal, become the champion.
Buckle up tight, folks. Here we go. Green flag is out.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Talladega Super Speedway as we get ready for the running of the Amp Energy 500 version 1. Snickers Cup Series action ready to take this racetrack for 29 laps of racing as this is Snickers Cup Series Division 1. On the pole for this race is going to be Aaron Williams looking for his second win of the season and his fifth Snickers Cup Series win of his career. He's going to be sponsored by Navy here today. Alongside of him is going to be rookie Cade Stewart, who will have the sponsorship of Arby's on his Roush Fenway Racing Ford. Brandon Bain, another former winner this season, he's going to line up in third place. That 82 car has quite a storied history here at Talladega Super Speedway. Of course, that's with Arnold Columbia last season. And alongside of Brandon is going to be Justin Acosta, who's really been having a great season so far in that 60 team, doing really well right now in the point stages as that rookie. Another former winner, Dylan Young, will line up in the fifth position. Alongside him is going to be Joe Smith. So you got 300 cars lined up in first, third, and fifth for the drop of the green flag. Hendrick Motorsports, as we know, really has just been on a major momentum roll ever since the start of this season. Of course, Ryan Cooper, a Hendrick Motorsports car, won the Division 1 Truck Series race here. So we're going to have to see what happens here today, as here is the starting lineup for today's race. Dominant force here in the Snickers Cup Series. However, what is the thing we've all been saying all week long? Talladega always seems to play out in the favor of the underdog. Hendrick Motorsports, I don't think would fall under the qualification of an underdog team with the success they've been having. So, we're going to have to see if Talladega Super Speedway is going to conquer these Hendrick Motorsports drivers, or if these Hendrick Motorsports drivers can conquer Talladega. We're going to really have to see what's going to happen here. Who's going to survive at the end of 29 laps? A big opportunity for a lot of these drivers, though, to be able to get their season turned around, make last-minute moves to get into the All-Star race. Hey, a lot of these drivers, I'm sure, have at least four or five different agendas for the win they could possibly get here today. But here we go, Aaron Williams coming down here to the stripe. The green flag is out, and we're underway at Talladega Super Speedway. What a perfect scenario for Aaron Williams. Actually, I thought it was going to be a perfect scenario. You had 300 cars lined up, 1, 2, 3. I thought they were gonna be able to work together there, as they were going to be one behind the other for this start-off. But Justin Acosta had other plans. He does a crossover move underneath Cade Stewart, and now he crosses over underneath Aaron Williams. Justin Acosta wants to lead the first lap. What an impressive run. Impressive few runs Justin Acosta's been having there for Germain Racing, and he's going to try and put it to work here early on in the Amp Energy 500, as he's going to come out of turn number four. comes Rhett Yates there as well. That's another driver who's been having a great run as a rookie. Doing very well in the standings is Rhett Yates. And down to the stripe, it will be Justin Acosta leading the first lap. Of course, we're not exactly that unfamiliar to rookie Acostas doing well in the Snickers Cup Series. Think back to Season 3. John Acosta came in replacing his brother, who was out with an injury. Ended up winning a race and doing very well in the chase for the Snickers Cup Series Championship. So, Justin Acosta feeling in the same way here. Except he's running a full-time schedule with Jermaine Racing. And tell you what, can't cast any predictions yet, but if he continues up the good runs he's been having, you could very likely see that 60 car in the chase for the championship. As here comes Jordan Hester, last week's winner at Hidden Valley, battling side-by-side there with Aaron Williams. And there's another driver there that's in a new paint scheme. You might not recognize him, that U.S. Army Chevrolet right there in the middle. That's James McLeod. If you didn't check out the latest stories over on NSRARacing.com, you did not know that James McLeod moved from Richard Childress over to Earnhardt Ganassi Racing for the rest of the season, driving the U.S. Army Chevrolet. Be sure, guys, to check out NSRA Racing Series at Weebly.com. For up-to-date stories on what's going on in the NSCRA, it gives you some updates, and one of those was about James McLeod's move over to the Earnhardt Ganassi Racing Stables. As right now, it's going to be Zohar Manid battling side-by-side with Richard Earnhardt there, 3x3x3, and I think, yes, Eric Burton's going to go 4 wide there. Eric Burton sponsored this week by BAM Racing. As he's drafting Jordan Hester. Hester looking awfully doggone strong right now as he's looking for his second win of the season. His win last season came on fuel mileage. Last week. Came on fuel mileage at Hidden Valley. And oh no. They're going to try going 5 wide. Don't do that. Looks like they settled it back out to 3 wide. But it looked like for a moment there, Richard Earnhardt was thinking about going 5 wide, going underneath the Eric Burton, and that would have been catastrophic. There's no doubt about that. Here comes John Castle down to the inside. We know that John Castle's got a little bit of a resume for restricted plate racing. Ended up qualifying for the Daytona 500 on speed. So, John Castle obviously has a good car today. I bet this is probably the same car they raced at Daytona. So he's now got a rear deck lid full of Chris Dollerton. Keep in mind, Chris Dollerton had a great run in his 36 car in the Mobile One Cup Series. And now he just gets shuffled out of line there by Max Skinner. We got a few drivers who were running at the back of the pack a moment ago at the start of the race. You got the 64 of Devaro Broin sponsoring Skittles. You got Arnold Columbia. You got Sophie Dillon. And you've got Ethan Hamill making only his second career Snickers Cup Series start. Side-by-side for the lead. Devaro Broin will go to the lead. Oh, they're wrecking! I think. Or did they just scrape the wall? Did they keep it together? Oh, I'm trying to look back here. Is there a caution flag flying? I can't tell. Yes, there is. And it's... Oh, it's Rhett Yates! Who comes in top to the stairs. And they're wrecking again! Henley gets a chunk of the wall. Ricky Hawk's around. Jody Wilson was in it. And there was just too much smoke to tell who else was in it. They'll race it back to the stripe. We've got two wrecks that occurred. Rhett Yates went flipping in the middle of turns 1-2. And there goes the 48 of Alexandra Williams around. She's sliding and spinning. And down to the stripe. Oh, man, that was close. Who was it? Was it Joe Smith? Still waiting for the word. It was Leo Rogers. Leo Rogers just barely got Joe Smith and Ethan Hamill at the stripe there. Leo Rogers leads under the caution. Oh no! Justin Acosta, we were talking about him. He was doing so well in points as well. There is Alexandra Williams. She's coming down pit road. No doubt she flat spotted the tires. She got spun off the corner by, I couldn't tell who it was. Oh man, there is Rhett Yates. His car flipped over. And that car came running in the top 10 standings, we know for sure. Cade Stewart, James McLeod, last week's winner Jordan Hester, Eric Burton may have been caught up in that follow-up wreck. There's Jody Wilson, who I know is in it, along with Ricky Hawk. And Sean Henley's got heavy-duty damage. He got turned straight up into the outside retaining wall. He took quite a lick there. Can't really document all the drivers that were involved in that because there was just so much smoke there on the back straightaway for us to be able to see. But it looks like the drivers will be making pit stops, so while they do make their pit stops here on lap 7, we'll take a look at a replay of the three different incidents that went down just a lap ago. Well, I love the spectator view, so you can see what happens when they head into turn number 1. Right there, you got Rhett Yates, and he and James McLeod just make a little bit of contact there. They bounced off each other, and it sent them both up the racetrack into Justin Acosta, who had absolutely nowhere to go. Oh, man, Rhett Yates flipped over once, then gets into Acosta, who's up on his side, almost on top of James McLeod's machine. And look at Rhett Yates, nose scraping there, upside down. Yeah, Justin Acosta, for a while there, was up on top of the hood of the U.S. Army Chevrolet of James McLeod. A tough break there for James and Justin, as well as Rhett Yates. And he just actually slides through turns 3 and 4 all the way down here. Down the banking, finally hits the apron. And then right there, I think when he catches the grass, that's what's going to maybe flip his car back over. Or maybe his car never did flip over. There it is. Yep, the catch is the grass. The car's going to flip over once. And then back around one more time till it lands on all four wheels. But both Justin Acosta and Rhett Yates, I can tell you this for a fact, they came in running top 15 in points. And Talladega has swallowed them up, swallowed up their chances of a good finish here today. We got to jump ahead now and see what happened exiting turn number 2 on the back straightaway. Let's try and see if we can figure out where this started. Who's the first car to get out of shape? Trying to look here. Oh, just maybe... Oh, right there. It was Cade Stewart and Eric Burton making some contact. They go up the racetrack. Oh, and Jordan Hester gets squeezed into the wall. Henley nowhere to go. Anthony McCurry gets a chunk of it. Is that the 3 car around there of Eric Matthews? I can't tell. Yes, it is. Jordan Hester gets a piece of it. And then watch Ricky Hawk. Oh! Nowhere to go. He just gets hit there by Sean Henley. And then you got Jody Wilson and Aaron Williams who both got a piece of it as well. Brandon Bain may have gotten a chunk of it too, but I'm not certain. Oh, and then Aaron Williams gets a piece of Ricky Hawk there as well. Wow. Whoa, and then Aaron Williams, I don't think he was too happy with Ricky Hawk right there. He then came down into Ricky. But Henley sustained the most damage out of all the drivers involved in that incident there. No doubt about that. Oh, there's Zohar Monod. He may have gotten a piece of it as well. Can't tell. Maybe he slowed up in time. There's Richard Earnhardt, Eric Burton, last week's winner Jordan Hester, Cade Stewart back there, as well as Eric Matthews right there in the 3. And Jody Wilson, we know, also got a piece of it as well. Now we got to look up ahead and see who it was that turned the 48 around. It looks like it may be Logan Wilson in the 99. Let's watch. Or not, that's not Logan Wilson. That's Jake Baskinger. That's Jake Baskinger in the 99. I'm sorry. Logan Wilson drives the 99 in the trucks. That's what I got them mixed up with. And yeah, he just gets into the Lowe's Impala. Former winner this season, Alexander Williams. Now let's see if Williams got the wall at all. I couldn't tell before. Oh yeah, oh, right front and right rear both into that inside retaining wall. That's pretty heavy duty damage there. That was over 100 miles an hour that she hit that wall at. To kind of remind you guys of 2007, Jimmy Johnson and Casey Mears getting turned off turn 4, almost looked exactly like that kind of an incident there, except I think Casey Mears took a little bit harder of a hit than Alexander Williams did. Mears had to retire. I think Alexander Williams will be able to continue, but we'll have to find all that out as we get ready for the restart. Let's see how the pit stops may have shuffled up the field. Well, the pit stops shuffled up the field all right. That car looked familiar. Yeah, that's the car that we just showed for our last caution, that spin off turn 4. But Alexandra Williams, when she spun, she came down pit road just before they closed pit road off to the drivers that would be coming and making their regularly scheduled pit stops. So she did not get penalized. Therefore, when the drivers did come down pit road, she was able to stay out, and she's inherited the lead. Talk about using your circumstances for your good. Alexander Williams is the leader here at Talladega as we get ready to go back under the restart on lap 11 of 29. Joe Smith is going to restart second, Ethan Hamill in third, Dylan Young fourth, Leo Rogers, who came down pit road, is the leader. He'll restart in fifth. Sophie Dillon, his teammate, will run in sixth. Seventh, Arnold Columbia. Eighth, Kyle Sanofsky now. We haven't talked about the 11 all day long, and there he is right now in the Autism Speaks Toyota Camry. Then you got William Duncan in ninth, and 10th is DeVar O'Broin. John Castle, 11th. 12th is Chris Dollerton. Jake Rogers up to 13th. 14th, Bob Fergus. 15th, Felix Harris. 16th is Brandon Bain, 17th Max Skinner, Eric Matthews 18th, 19th place is Ricky Hawk, and Zohar Mondet is 20th, 21st Richard Earnhardt, Jake Baskinger in 22nd, Anthony McCurry 23rd, Aaron Williams the pole sitter back in 24th, 25th is Ralph Mason, 26th is Jody Wilson, 27th Eric Burton, 28th James McLeod, 29th is Kate Stewart, and 30th is Jordan Hester. There you see Luke Walker in the 31st position. I think he just made a pit stop again. And drivers out of this race include Sean Henley, Justin Acosta, and Rhett Yates. They'll get 32nd, 33rd, and 34th today. Well, Alexander Williams, let's see if she's up to speed. Did they get that car repaired well enough for her to be able to stay out in front? Looks like it. Looks like she got a pretty good restart there. But Joe Smith's going to try and get around on the high side. That's not exactly the way to go unless you got a big bunch of drafting partners up high. And there you see the consequences Joe Smith's going to pay as Ethan Hamill's going to go down low and he's going to draft with the 48 of Alexander Williams. But not for long. Now Ethan Hamill's hooking up the drafting help of the 24 of Dylan Young. But Dylan Young says, thank you very much. I'm going to go even lower and I'm going to try going for the lead here. Dylan Young, another driver who has a storied history with Talladega Super Speedway. Got a Truck Series win here. Always seems to run well when they come to this restricted play track. And the other driver that really has a good run here all the time at Talladega, running right there, right in the middle groove there. He's now drafting with Sophie Dillon down low. That's Arnold Columbia. He's in the 23 this season, but last season in the Talladega race, didn't finish so well in trucks, but he won the Mobile One Cup Series race and the Talladega race in the same week. Big repertoire there for Columbia as he's now going to try and go to the lead here in season four. Let's not forget, he's a former winner this season, won at Phoenix. And Columbia would love to win again here at Talladega. Oh, contact right there between DeVar O'Brien and Jake Rogers. That was awfully close. Jake Rogers going to be moving over to a Dodge next week in that two car. But he's been running very well in the Ford, though, as he's, I believe, top 10 in the points. And here comes Brandon Bain looking to the inside. Drag race to the line. Just barely missed it. Columbia did lead that lap. As a matter of fact, how ironic is it? The battle to the stripe came down between the driver, Arnold Columbia, and the car he won the Snickers Cup Series event last season in. That number 82, and I do believe it was the Gatorade sponsorship, the white and silver Gatorade sponsorship that he won in, not the Pepsi sponsorship, but still, it was that ride, that team, that number. And right now, Brandon Bain's going to check out, and he's going to lead this race. Brandon Bain, a former winner of the season, won, I believe it was at Texas. So here they come down to the stripe. Take a look at Ralph Mason. He restarted way back in the pack. I think he restarted somewhere around the 25th position. Oh, he makes contact. Whoa, my goodness. I thought he and Jake Baskinger were going to go up into the fence. That was close. As now it's going to be Zohar Mondet going to the front. Now, Zohar Mondet, let's not forget, I believe he actually had good runs in both trucks and mobile here this weekend. So he's trying to follow it up with a good finish here in the Snickers Cup Series. Wouldn't put it past him, but here comes Leo Rogers back to the inside. Getting drafting help from his teammate, Yes, it is his teammate. Yep, that's Everham Motorsports teammate and William Duncan. Yeah, Everham Motorsports has a lot of good drivers this season. And we're seeing quite a few of them up here at the front here this week. Or did I say Everham? I meant Penske Racing. My apologies. Whoa, almost contact between Penske, or between, wow, I'm failing right now, between Bob Ferguson and Chris Dollerton there into turn one, but to keep it together. Going back to what I was trying to say, Penske Racing coming in with a lot of good drivers and quite a few of them here in this field. The 93 of Sophie Dillon, the 91 of William Duncan, the 92 of Leo Rogers, and the 2 of Jake Rogers. As now it's going to be a battle between teammates. Jake Rogers down to the inside, a little brother Leo. Side by side for the lead. It looks like it's going to be Jake Rogers taking the advantage off this corner. Jake Baskinger right there as well for Roush Fenway Racing. Then he got Eric Matthews up there in the 3 car. Let's not forget, he was involved in that first incident of the day. Now, there's a car off the pace back there. I'm trying to tell who it was. See if I can find out when they come here out of turn number 2. Well, that appears to be, believe it or not, the driver who led us down to the green flag, Alexandra Williams. She must have lost the draft. She's got to hook that back up here. Looks like she's going to be able to, though. She's trying to catch the draft of William Duncan. We got a few drivers running away at the back here who were involved in incidents, including Cade Stewart. I think Luke Walker may have actually been on pit road just before we're getting ready to go back to Green Flag Racing. Luckily, he didn't lose the draft of other drivers. He was able to catch up to this pack of cars. Eric Burton in that as well, along with Jody Wilson. These are drivers that basically were caught up in that first incident of the day. There's the pole sitter, Aaron Williams, running all by his lonesome in 28th place. Jordan Hesder back in 29th, and James McLeod back in 30th. Running way back. Oh, there's a spin! There's a spin! Who is it? Oh, my goodness, it's Jody Wilson, Cade Stewart, Ethan Hamill, and Arnold Columbia. These are drivers who were in that second pack we were just showing you. And here they come out of turn 4. Devaro Broin is the leader right now. Zohar Monnet second. Dylan Young battling side by side with Jake Rogers for third. Young will take that. Rogers third. Duncan will be Rogers fourth, and Duncan will be fifth as they take the caution. There's Columbia, Cade Stewart, Ethan Hamill, and Jody Wilson. They were the drivers that were involved in this. You gotta think this whole thing started with Columbia, just due to the fact that he was running in the first pack when that caution came out. Let's take a look at a replay. Take a look at it. I think this contact may start between Ethan Hamill and Arnold Columbia. Columbia actually drafting the car he won in last season. How ironic is that? Oh, they went 5 wide. Felix Harris, Ralph Mason, Sophie Dillon. That bounces them up into Ethan Hamill, who then gets into Arnold Columbia. Oh, man. First time in quite a while we've seen them go 5 wide here at Talladega. And as we've said before, they can go 4 wide and there's no problems. You go 5 wide, though, you're in a world of trouble. And Columbia and Ethan Hamill, they're going to pay the price for it. What a tough break for Ethan, only making his second Snickers Cup Series start. Gets introduced to the Talladega outside safer barrier in a rather unkind way. And then watch this second pack of cars come in here. Nowhere for these guys to go. Cade Stewart nails Columbia. Eric Burton and Jody Wilson nail Ethan Hamill. Burton actually, I think, got through. But Cade Stewart, he plastered Columbia. Jody Wilson plastered Hamill. That was some pretty hard licks taken by both of those drivers. Look at Aaron Williams picking up 3 or 4 valuable positions off in the racetrack. He's able to sneak his way through this 4-car incident. What a tough break for a lot of those drivers, though. Jody Wilson, Arnold Columbia, Ethan Hamill, and Cade Stewart. Wow. That's some hard licks that were taken right there by all 4 of those drivers. Let's go back to Green Flag Racing now. We'll get ready to go back to Green Flag Racing. We will have a total of 9 laps remaining when it takes place. And the pit stops were done again, and it cycled this field around even more. Zohar Monnet is now the new leader after Devaro Broin was actually the leader when we took the caution. Let's first show you the drivers out after this incident. They are the cars of Arnold Columbia, Ethan Hamill, Cade Stewart, and Jody Wilson. I've actually got a look here. Luke Walker, I did see him with some damage earlier. Wasn't enough to retire, but he is one lap down to the leaders. He'll start at the tail end of this long line due to there being less than 10 laps remaining in this event. Zohar Mon is the leader. He's looking for his first Snickers Cup Series win of his career. Dylan Young looking for his second of the season. He's going to roll off in second. William Duncan third. Richard Earnhardt fourth. Jake Rogers will be fifth. Sixth will be Kyle Sanofsky. Seventh will be John Castle. Eighth, Bob Fergus. Ninth, Max Skinner. And Chris Dollerton will restart in 10th. 11th will be Leo Rogers. Anthony McCurry, 12th. Devaro Broin, who led us under the caution flag that last time, came down pit road as the leader, but left in the 13th position. 14th will be Jake Baskinger. Brandon Bain, 15th. 16th, Ricky Hawk. 17th, Felix Harris. 18th place will be Eric Matthews. Alexander Williams, 19th. And Ralph Mason, 20th. 21st, Sophie Dillon. 22nd, Jordan Hester. 23rd, Eric Burton. James McLeod, 24th. 25th is Aaron Williams. 26th is Joe Smith. And 27th, one lap down, that is Luke Walker. Pace car peels off. We will have 9 laps, or make it 8 laps to go, when we get the green flag. Yep, they've confirmed. 8 laps to go. 8 lap shootout to decide this race. Who's going to do it? We don't know what strategy each driver used to be able to be where they are for this restart. Some of them may have taken only fuel. Some of them may have taken fuel and 2 tires. Some of them may have taken 4 tires. We'll have to see what strategy it is that's going to play out into the favor of which driver. And Zohar Mon got a doggone good restart there, but that's usually not a good thing at a restricted plate track. You do it at an intermediate track, a short track, hey, then you're smooth sailing. You're not going to get a challenge for a while. But you do it here at a restricted plate track, you're basically, pardon the phrase, a sitting duck. But maybe Zohar Mon will have things work out for him. If they're going to go 3 wide for second, that's the best case scenario there for the Aaron's Dream Machine. Zohar Mon trying to get an Aaron's Dream Machine to victory lane for the second time in 2 weeks. Evan Gattuso put the number 40 Aaron's Toyota Camry in victory lane last week at Hidden Valley. That was in Division 2 of the Snickers Cup Series. As now it's going to be a drafting duo of Kyle Sanofsky and Jake Rogers working to try and maybe get past Zohar Mon here. Nope, Sanofsky says, actually, I'm going to go with my fellow Toyota down low, and he'll go to the back bumper of the Aaron's Dream Machine. Max Skinner coming up here as well. Skinner's been having quite a few poor runs as of late. As a matter of fact, the only thing we really remember Max Skinner for is that he was the pole sitter for the Daytona 500 at the start of the season. He wants to get back into the win column. As here comes Kyle Sanofsky. He will take the lead. There's another driver who really needs a good run. Been having some tough luck here in the Snickers Cup Series. And doing very well right now here, running in the lead. But, oh man, he slipped up. He got a little loose off that corner. That's going to allow Chris Dollerton and Max Skinner to go to the inside. 3 wide. Leo Rogers thinking 4 wide. 4 wide for the lead. Leo Rogers drafting help from Zohar Mon. Leo will go to the front. Wow, what a power move there. And here comes Zohar Mon now. He's trying to hook up some drafting help from Brandon Bain, but Bain leaves him out to dry. Bain wants to go for the lead himself. 3 wide for the lead again. You can feel the urgency now. These drivers making these moves that may put them in position to come down as the leader when the checkered flag waves. Watch it. Little loose off that corner were both Felix Harris and Devaro Broin, but they keep it together. And now they're going to go 3 wide again. There's Felix Harris, one of those drivers who was involved in that 5 wide situation that took Ethan Hamill and Arnold Columbia out of this event. And look at Devaro Broin, 4 wide for the lead. They are racing like it's the last lap. This is the third time we've seen them go 4 wide into the first corner in the last 3 laps. And the leader is going to be Devaro Broin. William Duncan now to second. Ralph Mason into third. Sophie Dillon fourth, and Anthony McCrory now trying to move by Felix Harris. That's for fifth. It's getting down to crunch time now. We're going to come down to the stripe. There will be 4 laps remaining in this event. These drivers have to start planning what position they want to be in so that way they can make the move necessary to get the win on the final lap. We've seen drivers come all the way from 8th, 9th, and 10th to the lead in a whole lap to be able to take the checkered flag? Is that what these guys are strategizing? Or do they want to get right up to the front and lead this thing? But there's a wreck! There's a wreck! Look out! Brandon Bay, Leo Rogers, Jake Rogers, and Bob Fergus! This may be the race for the win! This could be it! We may not get back to the caution! Devaro Broin coming down out of turn number 4. Sophie Dillon right behind. Will she try and put a move? She's got Anthony McCurry helping, but she cannot. Not enough momentum. Devaro Broin takes the caution and possibly the win here in the Amp Energy 500 version 1. It just may have played out that this race will end under the caution. I saw several cars around. Oh, Jordan Hester was one of them, last week's winner. There is Brandon Bain, pole sitter Aaron Williams, Zohar Mana, Jake Rogers, James McLeod, Bob Fergus, Luke Walker, Leo Rogers, Chris Dalton. A lot of these drivers we saw running up at the front of the field. And the caution is out with 3 laps remaining. If we get back to the green flag, it'll be awfully interesting, but I don't know if we will. We got to look back, though, at a replay. Devaro Broin is the leader under the caution, who could be en route to his first Snickers Cup Series win of his career, his first NNSRA victory of his career. Let's look back at a replay now. Well, what an incredible turn of events here. A lot of these drivers were running up, battling for the lead not 2 laps ago. And we're going to have to see where this contact will begin. Trying to look here, I'm almost wondering if it started between Brandon Bain and Zohar Manad, but I don't think that's right. Gotta see here. Oh, the brothers, the Roger brothers get together. Jake Rogers shoves his little brother Leo up, and Bob Fergus, Zohar Manad, Brandon Bain, nowhere to go. Eric Matthews got a piece of that. In the 3, he's able to get down to the inside, though, to avoid further contact. Then Chris Dollerton gets a piece of Jake Rogers on the left side of your screen. Oh, man, what a lick right there. That was an awfully hard lick there for Brandon Bain. Joe Smith got a piece of that. Leo Rogers lining up there, and I think you're going to see there's Luke Walker and Aaron Williams coming into view. There's too much smoke to see where they make contact, though. Let's try going to a helicopter view. Yeah, you can barely see them now. This is the best view to be able to find out how these guys get involved. You see Jordan Hester there as well. We know he got a piece of this. Let's watch him as they come into view. Williams. Oh, man, they missed him. It looks like they missed him. They did get through that. But then how in the world did they end up having damage? Oh, wait a minute. They're coming up on the slower cars of Leo Rogers and Bob Fergus right here. And do they run into the back of them? Yep, they do. Oh. And someone else spun further up there in turn... Oh, there's Hester. Someone spun up in turn 4. Who was that? Was that Eric Matthews that spun? Yeah, it was. Contact from Alexander Williams. Right here, we can actually go to our regular TV camera angle now. Yeah, she just gets into the side of him and turns him around. And he goes sliding up into turn 4. I don't know if Alexandra Williams was kind of getting a little bit of revenge for what happened to her with Baskinger or what, but Eric Matthews and Jake Baskinger aren't even really buddy-buddy, and they're not even teammates either, so I don't know what the motive was there of Alexandra Williams, but nonetheless, Matthews gets spun around there in the turn 3 area. Not really going to hurt him that much. He didn't hit the outside retaining wall, and he had already been involved in that wreck that occurred on the back straightaway, but... just the carnage back here. Dollerton, Leo Rogers, Luke Walker, Jordan Hester, last week's winner, Bob Fergus, Aaron Williams actually, I believe after he hit the back of Leo Rogers. Oh, wow, Aaron Williams went for a much wilder ride than we expected. Watch this. He does get into the back of Leo Rogers, but watch right here. After he hits him, his car spins around, makes contact there with Luke Walker. That's how Walker's hood was buckled. Then more contact with Jordan Hester. That's going to send his car up the racetrack there. And Bob Fergus gets a piece of the outside retaining wall, trying to miss the spinning Navy Chevrolet. So it's not been a good day at Talladega for the pole sitter, Aaron Williams. No doubt about that. And there you see Zohar Manud, who was actually up battling for the lead. He was actually our leader to that last restart. Jake Rogers, James McLeod, Brandon Bain also involved. And there's Devaro Broing. Let's now go back, see if we are going to get back to Green Flag Racing. Whereas Devaro Broing won his first NSRA win of his career. White flag has been displayed, and the lights are still on atop the pace car, which means Devaro Broing, pending no mechanical problems here in these final four corners, will be picking up his first Snickers Cup Series win of his career and his first NNSCRA win of his career as well here in the AMP Energy 500 version 1 at Talladega Super Speedway. Want a little bit of history? That number 64 car going to go to victory lane one more time, as it's got quite a storied history. Lisa Shears ended up putting that car in victory lane at Bristol in season one. Aaron Williams ended up putting that car in victory lane three times last season and also made the chase in that ride. And Devaro Broing's going to add to the storied history of that 64 car as he's going to win here today at Talladega Super Speedway. You guys want a little bit more information? All right, I'll give it to you. Devaro Broing, going to win this race, comes into this race 101st in the point standings. Sophie Dillon, he'll finish second behind him, 99th in points. Anthony McCray, he'll finish third, 94th in points. Ralph Mason, he'll finish fourth, 93rd in points. And Jake Baskinger will finish fifth, 78th in points. If ever drivers needed a good run like this today, those five drivers are certainly going to be pleased with the top five runs they've been able to get here at Talladega Super Speedway. And wait a minute, Anthony McCrory is actually on the apron. Is he out of fuel? Oh boy, he's got to make it back around. He's got to make it back around to the stripe. Can McCrory do it? He's got it. Oh, wait a minute. I guess that was the checkered. Oh, there was the checkered. Okay, I thought there was a white flag, but that was the checkered flag. I must have missed that. So Devaro Broing, anyway, guys, it's now official. Is your winner at Talladega Super Speedway. He wins the AMP Energy 500 version 1. What a great day. And what did we say at the top of the program? Talladega always seems to play out to the favor of the underdogs. I think it did. Devaro Broing is going to move out of the hundreds, I believe, with this win today, as he came in 101st in the point standings. And he's going to have a victory here today. What an incredible race, and what great finishes for the top five, as none of them came in any higher than 78 in the point standings. Well, this is certainly going to shake up the points as well. Hope you guys enjoyed today's race. Please like, comment, subscribe to become a part of the crew today. We'll see you guys next time as we continue on the race weekend here at Talladega Super Speedway. You've been watching a production of the NSRA Offline Racing at its best.